Welcome to the channel for the first time, viewers. Welcome back for my existing subscribers. Today we're going to be talking about my experience with just the overall test servers and what I feel like you can expect from this new season of Ember Rise. So I'll talk a little bit about the operators. I'll talk a little bit about the map change, what I feel like some of the recall changes have been, what the overall game state kind of feels like with the meta changing, with the new operators being added in Amaru and Goyo. All right, let's get into it, man. So as some of you know, some of the SMGs have had their recoils kind of lowered. So that definitely helps a little bit, especially with operators like Amaru having the SMG 11, but really like with Bana, right? So I'll cover all the changes in a different video altogether, but overall, what I like about Amaru is how fast she can pretty much get into the objectives in the different sites. So one thing that I feel like a lot of people are going to appreciate about Amaru is that if you open up a hatch, you can actually use the grappling hook to go vertical again. So versus having to reverse all the way and go upstairs, you can just be right there and shoot through, but you can rappel back upstairs where you came from if you drop the hatch, which is something that we haven't been able to do in the past, so I really like that. Another thing that I like about her is that you can actually use the shotgun as your primary, and then which is the supernova. So if you've used Echo shotgun or Habana, it's the same shotgun. You can use that shotgun to breach the floor, and you have a SMG 11 as your secondary, which if you can control the recoil, makes it a very valuable asset to bring out to your loadout, especially being able to maneuver around the way you can and open up different lines of sight. This clip right here is actually one of the perfect examples of what I was talking about. Use the pretty much the shotgun to open up the floor, got an easy kill, and then just drop that hatch. I didn't go back up the hatch, I just kind of held the angle there, but it's the same as if you had brought a buck or a sledge or even a jackal to open up those same soft hatches. But now you have another operator that can do it. If you get good with the SMG 11, then you will really be a very effective Amaru player because of the creativity. Now she does have some downsides, like especially for the fact like if you bring a frost, she's defenseless when she's rappelling into areas. So there's a second or two where she actually cannot do anything. Like she can't shoot, she can't do nothing. So if you go into a window and you haven't droned it out, there's a good chance that if it's close to objective and somebody who's smart and knows that you've been using Amaru, that they put a frost trap there. So you're gonna go straight in there, or if there's a cap can trap on the window, or even one of those cap can Goyo shields, I mean, the sky's the limit. You can get really messed up if you're not paying attention to how you use her. But there are going to be some advantages to, you know, let's say, for instance, you're all the way downstairs for whatever reason. I can already see this. You're on, what's that map, border? Is it border? Yeah, it's border. And somebody knocked open the little office hatch, and they planted and get killed. That instead of having to rappel outside, you can just essentially grappling hook inside, straight up into the hatch, and then be already there. You can soft breach the wall and shoot somebody trying to defuse, or shoot them from the bottom, whatever's easier. You just have more options, which is always a good thing. As far as the canal remake, I kind of like the way they redid this map. I feel like that, I'm gonna be bad at explaining it, but the second way up, like when you can, because before everybody knows on canal, you can only really go up one way, and that was it, just the main stairs and then the other stairwell on the other side. But unless you went from outside, but when you're inside, they actually have more options for you to traverse now. And I really like that because I feel like it adds another level to the map. It makes it a little bit more competitive. It makes it easier for roamers, which I know that Ubisoft has been aiming for over their last few updates. They've been trying to do a lot of things with the making it easier for roamers to navigate the map and get around. So I think this is one of those things that the way they work this map out makes it less of a chokehold when somebody goes upstairs. Also easier for you to just like do a flank. So like say for instance, if you're downstairs and you need to do a flank, or you're roaming, it's not just that one stairwell that they have to watch or that one hallway anymore, and they completely cut off one side of the map, because that was the problem with it, and that's why it wasn't, in my opinion, in the ranked rotation before, is just that one specific hallway. Like on this clip here, if you look back into the back behind me on the left, that hallway was just it. Like if you control that hallway, then if the objective is on this side, they'd have to rappel into windows or come up the stairs to get you, and vice versa. If the objective was on the other side of the map, they literally only had the one choice of coming down that hallway or going upstairs via the roof. But now there's a lot more options as far as how you can get around. I also like the objective placements, so I think they did a lot of good things with this map. I'm interested to see how it actually plays out once everybody gets their hands on it, because you know sometimes when you see things in the test servers and then you see it live, people figure things out. They essentially, I swear, there's like a community of people that just try to break the game and figure out how they can do it. So we'll see what those people come up with when the time comes. And lastly, I'm going to talk about Goyo. He's going to be my favorite out of the two new operators, just because using Mirror's Vector feels like awkwardly, what's the word I'm looking for? It's awkwardly satisfying with a two-speed operator. The gun shoots really fast. You have decent movement speed. So if you go to like crouch and shoot, or you like go to do a quick peek, just having that two-speed operator makes the world the difference versus always using on one speed. Also, he has the DMR, so that TAC, that TSG-12, I think it is. Anyways, it's Kaid's shotgun. That is also the DMR. So he is a two-speed with an ACOG, and that's where everybody earlier this season was talking about, or earlier in the test server was talking about, are two-speeds getting ACOGs now, yada, yada, yada. So it's pretty much he has an ACOG option. It's a DMR, so it's not too OP. But definitely, I mean, Kaid had when he was a one-speed, and now this dude's two-speed, so we'll see how that plays out. And not to even mention how powerful his shields are in the closing seconds. Can't tell you how many times, like, the door, I mean, they burn for like 12 seconds. I think they'll lower that to maybe 8. But for now, they're burning for like 12 seconds, and I really don't see any teams that aren't very organized being able to pull off game-winning rounds, because the explosion really hurts you. So if there's anything other than that, you're toast. So step on a lesion, and it's going to slow you down, and you're in fire. Step on a cap can, it's going to kill you. It's going to be interesting to see how it all plays out. But let me know what you guys thought about this season overall, and if you're excited to play it. I think this might be a good one. So we'll see how it all actually turns out. You guys be easy, and I'll catch you in the next video.
One's on terrace.
You want me to open up mid wall?
Yeah.
One friendly remaining.
He's 1 HP. Yeah, Nomad's 1 HP, and so is Sophia.
Possum's literally last one. Operator standing.
Sure. Yikes! I think I'd be upset if this happened.